Well, I just got done attending the 2023 Pacific Shellfish Growers Association Conference. That was a lot of fun, but about an hour down the road is Oregon Seaweed. So today on the way home, I took the opportunity to stop by Oregon Seaweed and check out the operations. Oregon Seaweed is one of the largest, if not the largest, seaweed producer on the West Coast. Let's take a tour of this farm. Can't wait to get in there, and I love my seaweed.
I'm Nate Jones, Chief Scientist of Oregon Seaweed, and this is the largest land-based dulse farm on the West Coast. Oregon Seaweed's located in Garibaldi, Oregon, on the north end of Tillamook Bay. So the main species we're growing here is Pacific Dulse. It's a local species native to the Oregon coast. And we've found up to 30% by weight protein. Makes a really good protein substitute. And also really high in omega-3s and iodine, so it's a really good meat substitute for that reason as well.
Mm-hmm.
People like to do a lot of cool stuff with this. Traditionally, it's used in a lot of sauerkrauts. I've heard good results from kimchi as well. And Michelin star chef found if you deep fry it in peanut oil, it tastes like bacon.
Oh yeah, this stuff's really good.
So we use aquaculture here at Oregon Seaweed. There's a lot of good reasons to do that. Dulse works really well in a tumble culture. As you might be able to see, there's a lot of bubbles in our tanks, and that helps keep it circulating. It gets to share light, and we can put a lot of crop in a small area. Also makes harvesting really easy. We just dip nets straight in the tank, pull out whatever we need. And since this species doesn't have a holdfast, anything that we don't use can be recirculated. It's a zero food waste crop. Another other plus to aquaculture is we have a lot better water quality. Because we pump our water in from Tillamook Bay, there's a lot of freshwater inputs. We have five rivers here, six if you include the Columbia River. That's a lot of extra inputs we don't necessarily want in our system. Having on-land pump means that we can pump seawater in when we have nice, good quality seawater that's free of contaminants, and we can put that through a filtration system using a UV light to make sure we don't get any bacteria in our system as well. The other plus to using a UV light system is it reduces biofouling, so we can harvest year-round. Don't have to worry about too many extra inputs of biology coming into our tank. In nature, Pacific Dulse is both a clonal and sexual reproducing species, but here in the farm environment, we're focused on clonal because we like the attributes of our seaweeds. As these macroalgae are a clonal species, as they break apart, they become a new piece of dulse. So this does grow year-round, but it does vary depending on the time of the year because of different amounts of sun and temperature. So we see growth rates that vary from 0.5% to 5.5% by weight a day. We have a pump house that pumps in our fresh seawater into the system, and that goes into 20 large white aquaculture tanks, and that's where we grow our crop. Each of our tanks here at the farm are 10-foot diameter standard aquaculture tanks, and we have a tumbler bubbler system in the middle that keeps everything circulating, and when we pump water in the tide, it comes in through the top, and then we can drain out through the bottom, and a flow system that allows for constant recirculation of water. Tumbler culture, in a lot of ways, simulates the wave action in the ocean and the currents as well. As we use bubbles to help pull dulse to the up into the center of the tank, and that forces a current that flows along the surface and then back down to the bottom. That means all of our dulse is constantly circulating, and it all gets an equal amount of light. It also introduces dissolved gases into our tanks that help control pH and other dissolved gases like that. So a lot of people might think that you'd rather farm seaweed off the coast, but because of our rocky shoreline, very intense environments, and the amount of effort it takes to go out there, you get a lot lower labor costs, and it's a lot easier to farm here in an aquaculture system with a lot less inputs. Our systems here on the farm only use electricity, and it doesn't use much more than a couple houses or so. And not only is our carbon inputs low, but we're also pulling carbon out of our atmosphere, in part because of our Tumble system always putting dissolved gases back into our system.